Hi, I'm Andrew DuBourg and this is Off the Block. I'm chef patron of the Elderflower Restaurant. We're a husband and wife team realising a dream. Our ethos is very much quintessentially British with a sprinkling of French, and this is the perfect place. You know, I've got the sea on my doorstep and the forest a stone throw away, so. So the ethos of the Elderflower is always to respect nature, to go forage and show my staff. So we've got lovely little spots in the New Forest where we go and pick wild garlic when it's in season. I have great partnership with a local farm down the road, Lisa's Larder, where we get our lamb from, and we buy whole carcasses. And again, it's to show the chefs where their food comes from, to respect it, to not waste it. You know, our fish always comes in on the bone. And again, it's to also try and keep the skill set of butchery and fishmongery. I'm going to be cooking two recipes for you. So we've just put on a new dish, a celebration of Keyhaven lamb. We take out the loin, clean it up. So at the end of it, after pressing it as well, we get this, what looks like a small piece of pork belly. I don't do any water bathing, so we do the old-fashioned cooking. So we sear it up, cook it with loads of frothing butter, thyme and garlic. We take the breast and the belly and we glue those together. We glue the lamb belly and the breast together. We use a product called Activia EB. Then I'll cure it for 5 days with our curing salt mix. Then rinse it off slightly and smoke it for 18 hours. And then to mellow the smoke flavour and to tenderise the meat, we then confit it for 8 hours. And then that gets pressed for 2 days and then we cut little chunks and crisp it up. To finish the dish, we have the lamb bacon. We add an aromatic wild garlic sauce. We make a wild garlic pesto, which we put over the lamb belly. To represent where it comes from, we make nori seaweed rolls. We cook the sushi rice in lamb stock. We add mint reduction, chopped spring onions and roast garlic. And that then gets rolled and we steam it to warm it up. And we make an aromatic lamb jus, which we serve at room temperature to keep it beautiful and green, served with English asparagus. And lamb takes nice salty fish flavors on really well. Try not to overcomplicate the dish and just let the flavors come through it by themselves. Yeah, for me, I don't like meat to be too tender, if you know what I mean. You know where it tastes of butter. It's, if I'm chewing a piece of steak or lamb, I don't want it to be tough, but I want to know that I'm eating meat. My customers absolutely love the fact that I use Keyhaven lamb. With all our dishes, we have the lightest touch and we don't try to overcomplicate it.